Thank you. Ian Austin, New York Times.
Go ahead.
Hi, okay. Ian.
The $925 million, I'm a little puzzled. You talk about transparency a lot, but it looks like the inquiry came up with that number by doing something that any Canadian or anyone in the world can do, going to the Canada Revenue Agency charity site and adding up the numbers. So what exactly more transparency do you want? I mean, we know these groups appear at regulatory hearings, for example. Did you want, like, some law that they have to report specific Alberta things? And if that's what you want, should publicly traded energy companies and energy groups also be required to report what they spend on legal fees at regulatory hearings, what they spend on lobbying, advertising, and so on?
And they mostly do. It's called audited financial statements.
They do not write those numbers out in their
report. Called audited financial statements, and those energy companies and
publicly traded
corporations.
It's a broad category, but there won't be specific breakdowns like you seem to be calling for.
They're being asked to disclose climate risk and ESG considerations, and they are, and they're doing it because it's the right thing
to
do.
That's not lobbying. I'm talking about.
Sorry,
talking about
you ask your question. Can she answer?
Yeah.
Thank you.
All we're asking is environmental organizations should disclose the sources of their funding when it's from another jurisdiction and what it's used for. It's a fairly simple thing that they could do tomorrow. They could disclose that tomorrow, and they should. They should disclose it because it's the right thing to do.
Do you have a follow-up?
Yes, I do. Are you saying that if Northern Gateway had been built, oil prices would not be increasing right now? And is the province of Alberta opposed to the current increase in oil prices?
If Northern Gateway had been built, it would have been able to ship 525,000 barrels a day.
And on that note, that concludes this media event. Thank you.
Thank you.